Good day, good people of the interwebs. Today, I want to talk a little bit about how it was possible that the Emperor could walk around town without clothes. Because it's a very interesting folk tale. Now, the Emperor, obviously, being as good as he was, wanted the best of the best materials, and some snake oil merchant was smart enough to tell him that they had a cloth that was so pure, so refined, that only the brightest of people could see it. You had to be particularly stupid if you couldn't see these cloth. And apparently everyone fell for it. This story is quite interesting, but everyone will tell you, nah, come on, it's a story. It's not true. That never happens. The story of the clothes of the Emperor are indeed a funny folktale, and it's a kid that recognized that, hey, the Emperor isn't wearing any clothes. Now, unfortunately, this is happening in a lot of different topics as well. And first, I'm going to talk to you about one of the major topics this has happened in the last decade. And no, it's not Koof Koof. But trust me, Koof Koof will be next. The first major topic where they have used this is man-made global warming. Everyone will now tell you that, oh no, 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 all the science agrees, or 97% of the scientists agree, global warming is man-made. Okay, but that's not true. How do I know this is not true? I'm not a scientist. No, that's also correct. I'm not. I'm merely a social therapist. What the hell do I know? The thing is, however, I do know something. For example, I know that CO2, which is now being seen as the culprit of global warming, and it only happens to be the culprit because it's being produced by our societies, well, CO2 is also the most basic of plant foods. And we were at a very low CO2 only 50 years ago. Well, a bit more than 50 years now. How low was it? Well, it used to be around 250 parts per million. Had it dropped to 180 parts per million, it would have entered a global extinction of plants. This is not me saying this. This comes from biologists. That's why they were also upset about the low CO2 for a long time. This, by the way, is one of the reasons why farmers started farming in greenhouses, because you could pump CO2 in it. Which is a good thing, because it made plants grow better. And we are seeing that due to a higher CO2 in the atmosphere, plants are indeed growing better. A few years ago, NASA was able to tell us that this increased the greening of the planet by at least 70%. But still, we are being told that, yeah, but it also causes global warming. Now, often people cite a study that says, oh no, 79% of scientists believe global warming is true. Which sounds really good, but it's a hoax. Because yes, most scientists will tell you that global warming is indeed a real thing. But whether it's man-made global warming is a completely different story. Because our environment has constantly been changing. In the Middle Ages, we had the Middle Age Warm Period, which was, as stories go, warmer than today. And in the 19th century, we had the Little Ice Age, which is falsely named, to be honest, because it wasn't a Little Ice Age. We are still in an Ice Age, which most people don't seem to realize. But it is true that in the 1800s in Europe, there was a lot more ice. I mean, a circus on the Thames. I mean, the stories are there. The global warming thing that we have now can't explain any of the things we know were true in history. How do we know these things were true in history? Because we have images, we have stories, we have accounts telling about this. We know that in Denmark, they were being able to grow grapes to make wine, which is something that at this point in time isn't really possible because it's not warm enough yet. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not here to talk about how this, whether it is true or not, is a thing. What I'm talking about is the emperor having no clothes. Everyone told the emperor that he had beautiful clothes. He wasn't wearing a single thing, but the wise people around him didn't want to show that they couldn't see the clothes, because, hey, if you tell the emperor that he wasn't wearing clothes, either the emperor would be mad at you, or everyone would call you an idiot. Now, this is not a new thing, or rather, it's not a thing that only happens in stories. For example, if we look at Egypt, in Egypt, for the longest time, people were taught that they were the first to go to the moon. By the way, people in China believe this too, and people in Russia believe this too. The thing is, however, Russia actually came close. I mean, they were the first in space. Saying something that goes against the narrative in authoritarian states is a dangerous thing to do. For example, take the wife of Ceausescu. She was considered to be one of the smartest people in Romania. Oh no, she had all sorts of degrees. She hadn't finished any school, by the way, not even basic school, but the story was that she was really smart, and she got international papers from France, from Great Britain, from universities, sorry, not from the states themselves. And everyone followed along. Why? Because it makes a good narrative. Now, Romania had leverage because maybe they were planning on buying planes from France and the UK, and therefore France and the UK had a diplomatic motivation to go along in the lie. But in Romania, everyone had to follow the lie. There was no two ways about it. It had to be true, because if it's not true, then, well, you're not allowed to say it, because if you do, you go to jail. And this point is what I want to come back to, because this is what happened around the global warming thing. I mean, I've been kicked off LinkedIn because I said that the CO2 science hasn't been proven, only asserted. Mentioning that it's asserted was enough reason for me to get kicked from LinkedIn. Now, not that I care, fuck LinkedIn, but it does show you the dangers of proving that the emperor isn't wearing any clothes. The same is true for the Kuf-Kuf nowadays. Now, for more than 2 years, we've been grappled by the story of this terrible disease. A terrible disease with a survival rate of 99.9% for most of the public. But nonetheless, a terrible disease. So bad is this that the story has to be that people die from it, standing up and walking over the street and then suddenly dropping dead to the floor, which, by the way, never happened, but the story is still there. And when doctors say, okay, you know what, but we know how to deal with this, these doctors get silenced because it doesn't follow the narrative that needs to be pushed. And the narrative that needs to be pushed is, be afraid. This goes so far that now the only thing governments in the Western world applaud when it comes to the Kuf-Kuf is locking everyone inside, not having them go out into the fresh air, for example, or to sport, and everyone has to take a vaccine. A vaccine that had been pushed forward to be allowed to be released, even though there hasn't been a long-term study on it. But saying these things will most likely get you kicked off platforms. I mean, there have been doctors that have been ostracized because they claimed that they know better. How dare you know better? Because the scientists all agree. Well, it's easy for scientists to all agree if you basically deny every scientist that doesn't agree a platform to talk on. And this is what's happening once again. The only thing I can tell you people is I hope you will wake up. Because we can't trust our governments. We can't trust our media. Now, don't get me wrong. I'm not telling you to trust me. But please, be more self-active. Check things. And, you know, I might be wrong. And the next guy might be wrong. But we also might be right. As the image that I'm showing you now shows. For the longest time, a lot of things that have been called conspiracy theories are now reality. The emperor has no clothes. And we have to stand up and dare speak out. Because if we don't, we will never be free. Like, share, and subscribe if you feel so inclined. Criticism, as always, is more than welcome. And I hope to see you all next time.